हेलो गाइस, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड. आई एम वैशाली किकान एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग द VLSI टेक्नोलॉजी. इन दैट वी आर डिस्कसिंग द प्लाज्मा. आई होप यू ऑल हैव सीन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वेयर वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द बेसिक्स ऑफ द प्लाज्मा एंड द वेरियस बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स रिलेटेड टू इट लाइक द मीन फ्री पाथ. ओके, सो नाउ कमिंग टू द आयन बॉम्बार्डमेंट. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी हाउ वी हैव द आयन बॉम्बार्डमेंट जनरेटेड फ्रॉम द प्लाज्मा. ओके, नाउ कमिंग टू द आयन बॉम्बार्डमेंट, वॉट इज इट? Anything which is closer to the plasma will get ion bombardment. Okay, so now whenever we have anything, now the plasma is placed over it. In the plasma we have electrons and the ions. So in these electrons and the ions will be hitting the surface below it, and this process is called the ion bombardment. How it is generated, we are going to see the detailed procedure. So it is a very important concept for three processes, which is sputtering, etching and the PECVD process. Okay, so we are going to discuss about all of them and how plasma is important for all of them. So in the upcoming videos, most probably we are going to talk about the detailed procedure of sputtering, etching and PECVD using the plasma. Now the ion bombardment rate is determined by the RF power mainly. If I increase the RF power, so at that time ion bombardment will be increased. If I increase the pressure, that also affect the ion bombardment rate. And I hope now you understand, if I increase the pressure, ion bombardment will be increased. Now I have already discussed about the mass of electron and the mass of ion in the previous video. I have already told you that the mass of electron is very less as compared to the mass of ions, and this is the reason the electrons are moving faster. The electrons reach electrodes and the chamber wall first. Okay, I hope you remember it. So electrodes which are charged negatively will repel the electrons, whereas they will be attracting the ions. Ions, because they are having very high mass, they are not able to move even though there is some attractive force from the negatively charged electrode. So there is some sheath potential developed which accelerates the ion towards the electrodes, and this causes the ion bombardment. The ion bombardment is very important for etching, sputtering and PECVD, as I have already told you. So now comes the concept of the sheath potential which is accelerating these ions. Okay, so now you can see we have the sheath region. I have already told you what is the sheath region in the previous video. If you have still any doubt, go back and watch it first. Okay, so now you can see in the sheath region we have some potential Vp. Okay, so which is called the sheath potential. Okay, so now here we have the electrodes. So there will be some positive and the negative charges present in the bulk plasma. So here around the electrode we will be having the more and more of the positive charges, and here in the bulk plasma we will be having full positive as well as the negative charges. Okay, so in the sheath region you can see positively charged ions are moving due to the gradual decrease of the sheath potential from Vp to the Vf in this dark space. Okay, so when we are reducing the potential, the charges will get the enough energy to get attracted, and this is the reason they are moving fast. You can see we are getting highly negative potential which are attracting the positively charged ions, and this is the reason the ion bombardment will be happening. Now coming to the various applications of the ion bombardment, it helps to achieve an isotropic etching profile. Okay, when we want to etch out in all of the directions uniformly, I will be using the ion bombardment. In the damaging mechanism, in the blocking mechanism, both of these we are going to discuss in detail when we are going to discuss about the etching. It is used in the argon sputtering process, it is used for the dielectric etch, for the gap fill process and for the metal deposition process as well. Okay, so when we want to have the deposition of metal, we will be using the ion bombardment of the metal ions over the surface. Now it helps to control the film stress in the PECVD process. There is a very big problem of film stress that is created in the PECVD, which is easily controlled using the ion bombardment. If I have heavier ion, which means more compressive film. Okay, so you can see the plasma potential and the DC bias. The more the DC bias, we will be having more of the plasma potential, okay? So if the negatively charged voltage is very high, which means the ion bombardment rate will be very high. Okay, so you can see the RF potential is changing. It is alternating, which means the plasma potential is also alternating with time. Now coming to the DC bias and the RF power. If I have low RF power and the smaller DC bias, if I don't have any external power source, okay, so there will be less charges, less potential on the electrode. Okay, if the DC bias is also small, then you can see the plasma energy, plasma potential is lesser. Okay, if I have higher RF power and the larger DC power, so in that case the plasma potential will be very high. Okay, so if I want to have a higher plasma potential, I will be using the higher RF power. So ion bombardment will be controlled with the help of ion energy, ion density, and both of them are controlled by the RF power knob. So RF power knob is the most important knob which controls ion energy as well as ion density. If I want to control the ion bombardment, I have to look for the RF knob. Okay, so increasing RF power, which means the DC bias will increase, the change in potential will be increasing, which means ion density will be increasing. Both ion density, also the ion bombardment energy, are controlled by the RF power. So I can say RF power is the most important knob controlling ion bombardment. RF power is also used to control the film stress in the PECVD process. You can see the DC bias of the CVD chamber. So you can see here we have the dark space. So these are the dark spaces. In the dark space, the potential is dropping significantly, which is causing the ion bombardment. The VP is around 10 to 20 volt, and here we will be having the around 0 volt, and sometimes we can have the negative potential as well. The more the negative this potential, the more will be the ion bombardment rate. Okay, so you can see the DC bias effect on the H chamber plasma. Okay, so you can see if I have the higher DC bias, the plasma potential will be high, which means the etching would be very high. Okay, so if I want to have larger etching, I require very high energy of the ions, so that I require high DC bias value. Okay, so you can see the DC bias here. So it can be, as I have already told you, it can be negative as well. And how I calculate it? So you can see here V1 is around 200 to 1000 volt, and V2 will be some positive value that I have already told you. It was around 10 to 20 volt. So how I can calculate the energy here? So now the ion energy will be proportional to V1 by V2, which is equal to A2 by A1 raised to power 4. Okay, so now you can see this is the A1 area of the electrode, and this is the area of the another electrode. So if I reduce the area A1, then I can have high V1 by V2 value. So when we have high V1 by V2 value, which means we have high ion energy. So if I want to increase the ion energy, I have to control the area of this electrode, okay, A1 electrode. Now coming to the question, if the electrode area ratio is 1:3, what is the difference between the DC bias and the self bias compare with the DC bias? Okay, so the DC bias is V1, the self bias is V1 minus V2. Okay, so how we can calculate it? So if I have A1 by A2 to be 1:3, so V2 by V1 will be equal to 1:3 raised to power 4, which is 1/81, which is around 1.23%. Okay, so I hope now you understood it. Now the question is, can we insert a fine metal probe into the plasma to measure the plasma potential? How do we measure the plasma potential? The V2 is the plasma potential that we have to measure it. I gave you the range, it is in between 10 to 20, but I have to calculate the exact range so we can insert a fine metal probe. However, it is not very accurate method because the sheath potential is near the probe surface. Okay, so measurement results are determined by the theoretical model of the sheet potential and we don't have any fully practical method developed yet. Now coming to the ion bombardment and the electrode size. I have already told you smaller electrode will be giving me more energetic ion and we will be having more ion bombardment due to the more of self bias. Etch chambers usually place wafer on the smaller electrode. So this is the reason if I have the wafer placed on the smaller electrode, there will be high ion bombardment which will be easily used for the etching purposes. Now coming to the advantages of using plasma. So plasma process will be giving me the dry cleaning also. So it will be removing the contaminant particles. So in the CVD, it is used for the chamber dry clean process. It is used for the plasma etching, for the ion implantation, for the PVD process. So these are the references. I hope you understood each and every topic that I have discussed. So if I missed anything and if you want to discuss anything in detail, you can refer these books. These are really amazing. So I hope you like this session. If you like it, please push the like button, subscribe to the channel, and also do share it with your friends. Thank you so much.